Come on.
Oh. Come on, old man.
Coming into Trinity Lane. Oh. Eyes on the road, Brian. Brian spies an opening. Oh, he's almost off. Hawking's lost it.
Slow, old man.
Too slow. Oh, whoa. Right. Have a drink. Yeah, because shite. Hello.
Bah.
What if the secret of the universe had something to do with sex, huh?
Hey, maybe do a doctorate on that. The physics of love.
I think that's more your field, Brian.
Oh, not lately. They will boot you out, you know, if you don't decide.
I know everyone here who's brilliant. Oh, dear. Scientists.
Ah, you made it.
Don't worry, we don't have to stay for long. It's mortifyingly dull. Pause. Who's that? Who's who? Oh, him. Oh, he's strange. Clever. Goes to ban the bomb marches.
Wild. Jane Wilde.
Oh, look, it's David. David? I'll be back in a minute. David? Yeah, I'll be back in a minute.
Hello.
Hello.
Science.
Arts.
English.
French and Spanish. What about you? What are you?
Oh, cosmologist. I'm a cosmologist.
What's that?
It's a kind of religion for intelligent atheists.
Intelligent atheists?
You're not religious, are you?
C of E. Church of England?
England, yeah. Well, I suppose someone has to be.
What do cosmologists worship, then?
What do we worship?
Mm.
One single unifying equation that explains everything in the universe.
Really?
Yes.
What's the equation?
That is the question. And a very good question. I'm not quite sure yet. But I intend to find out.
Then why didn't you stay at Oxford?
Because my finals exams were such a shambles that the examiners, they summoned me in for a viva, and they told me that if I got a second...
What's a viva?
It's a sort of mildly terrifying face-to-face thingy.
Like an interview?
An interrogation. And I told them that if they gave me a second-class degree, then I would stay with them and do my research at Oxford. But if they gave me the first that I need to get into Cambridge, then they would never have to see me again.
They gave you the first.
They gave me a first.
Of course.
This party is officially deceased. Come on, I fixed you up a ride home. Come on, Jane. Jane.
Well, it was lovely to talk to you.
Yes.
And I hope you find your equation.
Yes. Oh.
Bye.
Bye.
Stephen?
Oh.
Yeah. Well then, here we are. Little challenge for you all as you embark upon your separate doctoral journeys, whatever they may be, Mr. Hawking. Pass them down. Something to separate the men from the boys, the wheat from the chaff, the masons from the pie masons, the quarks from the quacks. 10 questions, each more impregnable than the last. Good luck. You'll need it. Shall we say Friday, 3 o'clock?
This is going to hospitalize me.
And one, drive! Two, drive! Three, drive! Can I get two more of those, please?
Yeah, sure.
Some change for the payphone.
Yeah.
Dave, you're right, mate.
I mean, you'll never guess who I saw him with the other day. Caroline. I mean, for heaven's sake, she can have him, quite frankly.
What's the probability?
Reasonably low. This is Stephen.
Do you play croquet?
Croquet? Not recently.
Sunday morning?
Actually, busy Sunday mornings.
Oh. Him. Okay.
Anyway, I was really interrupted.
How many did you get?
Morning, Brian.
Good afternoon, Stephen. How many of the impossible questions did you do?
Brian, I have no idea what you're talking about.
How many of Sharma's questions did you get, Stephen?
None.
You didn't get any?
I was going to do them later.
You haven't even looked at them?
No.
Stephen, are you aware that you've voluntarily embarked upon a PhD in physics at the most prestigious college in England?
Yes.
Oh, I thought maybe you'd slept through the induction or something.
Right.
What?
Can you whip on some Wagner?
Sod off.
Come in, Stephen.
Sorry.
Michael, that's so illegible, I can't quite decipher how wrong it is. I suspect enormously. And Brian, that's just baffling. Have you even bothered, Stephen?
Oh, sorry.
Right. Train timetables. It's totally unacceptable. These expired a month ago.
Oh, it's on the back. I had a little accident.
Ah.
I could only do 9.
Oh. Oh, thank God. Bravo.